But next day it was a little better. I ran a block and a mailbox, then a block and two mailboxes. I'll never forget when I ran all the way around that huge block. I woke the family up to tell them what I had done. Nor will I ever forget after a number of months. I kept hearing people say, man, you're going to feel so good. Your energy level will be so much higher. You're going to love it. Shoot, I hated it every time I got up to do it. I really did. And then one day I was in Portland, Oregon. I'd been doing it about 10 months. And in Portland, Oregon, I was jogging on the Portland State University campus. I ran past a number of people as I was running, and all of a sudden it hit me that I was breathing easily. I was moving smoothly. Then I realized what they were talking about. I went through a lot to get there, but I got to tell you that it really was rewarding in so many ways. But I think the key to the whole thing, I'll never forget, I spoke in Seattle, and flew up that morning, spoke, came back, got in bed about 2 o'clock in the morning. Now, I'd set my opportunity clock. You know, some people call them alarm clocks, but if you can hear it, that means you can get up and go. That's an opportunity. If you can't hear it, that might mean you done got up and gone. Well, anyhow, at 2 o'clock in the morning, when that opportunity clock sounded off again, I lay there and I said, Ziegler, you don't feel like doing this. Man alive, you're not going to be worth a hoot all day long if you get up now. Why don't you, the night before I'd gone through this one, I lay down, you know. Bottom line is I got up, and I was right. It was a miserable run. I had a miserable day. But I believe that day was a turning point in my life. I didn't want to do it, didn't feel like doing it, but I did it. I'll admit, I slept 2 or 3 hours that day. But the point I'm making is that once you've made that commitment, once you're consistent in it, once you discipline yourself, nobody else can discipline you as well as you can discipline yourself. That's when I was able to do some amazing things. At age 74, incidentally, just to show you the importance of continuing at it, at age 74, I stayed on the treadmill at the Cooper Clinic longer than I could stay when I was 45 years old, overweight and out of shape. So it paid off, the consistency. We're physical, mental, and spiritual, and we do need to take care of the temple of our soul. We sure do.
You know, my pastor puts it this way, with consistency, your burden will become your blessing.
And he puts it well, too. I couldn't think of a better way. I'm glad I thought of that.